There has been so much talk about this young rookie, Ray. What's going through his mind here before he does it for real on the ice?
Well, by the time he gets to the point where he's about ready to step on the ice for the game, he's burned some energy already, James, in warm-up, but he's had time to think. So, you know, he's nervous, he's excited, he's anticipating his big moment, but this is a blur. He's not going to remember any of it.
James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. Toronto's up 1-0. Puck scooped up by Edmondson. Loses possession after he takes a little hit. Excellent stick work on the play. Good hit to pump him off the puck. Montreal's got control of it now from their own end. The official signaling for a penalty as play is called. The Leafs are going to be shorthanded because of a tripping call.
Funny, coaches always tell you, get your stick on the puck. And then when you try and the guy trips up, they tell you, get your stick up.
Goaltender gave up nothing as it hits the outside of the post and will play on. Denies that opportunity. Slides the pass over to Deneau. Quick pass to Drouin. Gains the zone on the left wing. Levels him with the hit. Laying the body. Drouin is going to play it against the half wall. The Leafs gain control of the puck against the wall. Wrister, big hit. And puts it just wide.
The goalie was late reacting. If that puck hits the net, I think it's in.
Taken by Brody. Puck grabbed by Tavares. Here they are on the attack. Toronto's got the puck along the boards. Bringing the physicality tonight. Coming down the left wing and into the zone. Angles it over to Tavares. Nice dish from the left wing. Oh, had a chance to make a nice move, and the puck disagreed with him.
There are times you try to do too much. He's got good hands, but maybe a more simple play is the right one there.
Quick feed to Tavares. With possession along the wall. Couldn't make that one happen. The Canadiens scoop it up along the boards. And now it's grabbed by Weber. Slides the puck over. Here he is in close. Gobbles the puck up there with the chest.
The rookie's been a big part of this team, and the coach has gone to him here, James, because they have got nothing going on. It's been a flat, listless performance.
Yeah, they've been absolutely lifeless out there. They need a shock or something to wake them up. The Canadiens have had multiple scoring opportunities, but they still trail in the second. Puck picked up by Edmondson. Here's a short pass to Kotkaniemi with authority. Aaron pass, and the play's broken up. And the puck's knocked loose. Brody's got it in the defensive end. Toronto's moving it into the offensive end. Quick snap, stones him in front.
Sometimes you're in close, there's no room to put it anywhere. The goalie smothered it all. Price makes a terrific stop, but he doesn't get all of it, and he's pretty fortunate it doesn't bounce off him and into the net.
Moves it to Tatar. Streaking through center, they go on the attack. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Moves it quickly over to Toffoli with the stop.
Anderson's been a strong link in the chain tonight. Everybody's pulling in the same direction. The offense has been excellent too.
Montreal's been the busier team offensively with way more shots on goal, but they still trail in the second. Tosses it on to Tavares. Let's it go! Scores! And the rookie gets his first!
Well, that didn't take very long. His first game, his first goal. The hype has been realized. They'll never forget that one. The rookie scores his first career goal. Attaboy, you're on the board. The rookie's had a really good game, and he gets a little tap from the coach as he comes back to the bench. That doesn't happen very often. Pretty satisfying when you know the boss is happy with you.
We've called his name multiple times. He's been all over the ice tonight. Ray, as a rookie, how long did it take for you to score?
Took me 3 games, and it was a great thrill. I can't even imagine what this feels like.
This neutral zone faceoff set to go, and we are back underway. Gets the puck in deep. Toronto's got a hold of it along the wall. Hall's moving the puck through his own zone.
12 minutes, 58 seconds.
The Canadians gain possession in their own end. Directs it on over to Toffoli. Moves it around along the half wall. Tries to make a move and can't hang on to the puck.
They're tied.
One-on-one with the goaltender! And that falls apart.
Well, that's disappointing. Nothing out of something that looked dangerous.
And a strong effort on that play.
The shooter's right in the guts of the ice, but the goalie squares up, spreads out, and makes the save.
There's the horn ending period number 2. I'm not sure they wanted it to end. And we are just moments away from the start of the 3rd period. Works it across to Tavares.
Well, this building isn't the only place that's buzzing tonight. With much more, we send it ringside to Carlin Bade.
You know what, James? The rookie is buzzing tonight, scoring his first career goal in his first NHL game, and the fans are loving it. Chell Diamond said, this kid
buries it for the goal.
I always wanted to have a fast start. It's funny, you go no goals in 3 games in the middle of the year, nobody cares. At the start, it really matters.
Ray, you're between the benches. Are you picking up on any of this?
Yeah, I thought a really good reminder here from the coach to his youngest player is that you're at a point in the game where safety is better than a creative play. Make the right play the smart play. Keep the puck in front of you.
The Leafs win the faceoff. Toronto's on the attack. Here's a shot. Turns it aside with the glove. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Toffoli. Montreal's got the puck against the boards. Good defensive effort to poke it away. And that's picked off in front. Gets it out of his own end. The Canadians move the puck in the defensive zone. And now he moves it quickly to Kotkaniemi. Takes the feed at the back end. Toronto's looking to break out of their own end. The Leafs move to the offensive zone. Strong defensive effort. Right in front of the net! Oh, what a stop with the stick!
He's sharp on that one. Nowhere to go for the puck.
Takes the pass. Enters the offensive zone from the left. Quick pass to Tatar. Denies him in front. Toronto's got the puck along the wall. Strong defensive effort. Quick feed to Dermott. The Leafs played along the boards. Here's a shot and makes the save. Less than 60 seconds left here in the final frame. And there it is! The freshman sensation scores.
I'm just going to say, I don't think the kid ever got an opportunity to really show what he could do in that situation. You saw how the coaching staff had really challenged him in that moment of the game. And I don't know if the way that things were going, how the coach was rolling lines, but also the disruption and the flow of the game, I don't know if the kid ever really got a chance to show.
Supposed to, yeah, recall. Well, phone lines are open and text messages already hopping away. What a job. What a performance. What a debut by the rookie. I mean, to snipe in your first NHL game, you talk about living up to the hype. There was a lot of pressure, a lot of eyeballs to see how he would respond. And to me, he passed the test with flying colors. Whatever that even means, flying colors. I'll tell you what, he aced it, love it. And I think there's a lot more in a bright, bright future ahead. Meantime, we're going to check in on some other stories going on. I'm seeing a lot of traction here on social media suggesting they're just trying to figure out where do they put that banner in the rafters with his name and number on the back of it already.
Well, we're early in season one for him, so it might be a tad hasty. But he has been fun to watch. I mean, he's out of the gate. He's had a good start. Had a big night last night. Not just getting on the board, James, but the way that he had the puck the whole time. I'm growing into a big fan early on in his
career. I get the excitement. I was going to say, like, I get the excitement, don't you?
Oh, yeah, for sure. But as far as, you know, can we retire his number? I'd like to see him get through a season first.
Well, okay. How about even a quarter?
No. Man, you were hasty. But you're hasty good and bad, too.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. Fan. Voice of the fan. Voice of the fan, Ray. And we'll have much more reaction. All right, at this time, let's get you caught up on all the action on the ice tonight. The Canadiens were on the road to take on the Maple Leafs. Toronto posts a shutout in a clinical performance defensively. How about the rookie in this one, scoring in the win? And here's how it all went down. Here's the rookie making things happen in the offensive zone. Shot scores! Oh, the freshman comes up clutch with the goal. There were other games on the ice as well across the National Hockey League. Let's bring you up to date on some of the finals. The Bruins were on the road up against the Capitals. Washington takes this one thanks to a strong defensive effort. The Ducks had a tall order to fill as they tried to take two on the road against the Sharks. Anaheim posts a win in a tightly contested affair. Lots more still to come, including the story in MMA, the hardwood, and more. Stay with us. All right, let's go around the horn and see what happened elsewhere around the NHL tonight. The Hurricanes were hoping to play spoiler against the Blue Jackets. Carolina trampled their opponents with a big offensive night. The Sharks took on the Kings. Los Angeles pokes home the shootout winner and the 2 points to go along with it. We got a jam-packed show. We've got a lot more stuff we got to get to, so don't even think about going anywhere. Stay with us. I'm really looking forward to this one. This has been one of those games on the regular season calendar that has been circled, a little save the date for a lot of fans. I'm looking forward to it as well. And I'm really curious to see how the kids going to respond when the intensity gets turned up. These two teams do not like each other. There is a long storied history between these two teams, a divisional rivalry that has a lot of magic on the ice for combustibility. Let's see how the kid responds in this one. You know, when you look at these two teams and how they match up. Hey, no shortage of action and drama on the ice tonight. Let's take a look at what happened elsewhere. The Senators were in a dogfight on the road against the Maple Leafs. Toronto tore it up on the score sheet, easily coming away with the win. Ray, what's the method to the madness for guys getting to the rink so early for a big game?
Well, when it is a big game, everything's a little different. You can feel it during the day. So generally speaking, guys get there a little earlier than they would normally. They tape their sticks, they listen to music, they want to lock in for a big one.
From the Windy City here in Chicago, Illinois, he's Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. He looks deep to Peary. There's the whistle as the puck flies out of play. Inching closer to the midway mark of this period, it's all tied up. The Leafs win it. Picks up the puck in his own end. Here's a short pass to Dermott. Nothing doing on that. Slides it across to Peary. Solid check to slow him down. Moves it to Tavares. It's a two-on-one. Smart heads up play to neutralize the threat. Hangs onto the puck. Takes a shot. Stopped by the goaltender. The Leafs will play it from the defensive zone. Receives the pass. Here's a chance right in the slot and just out of arm's reach on the play. I think it's a chance for a breather here as he hangs on and covers the puck up.
Who, for the players or for you?
Well, you know, I won't complain. Puck possession so critical. Another faceoff coming up here. Takes the feed. Grabbed along the boards by Tavares. The Blackhawks get a hold of the puck in their own end. Well, that'll do it for period number one. Opportunities at both ends of the ice create a little bit of offense. Fun start here. Period number two now underway. Let's see what this one has in store for us. Well, we've got over 20 minutes played thus far. Ray, how have you seen things?
The Blackhawks are lucky here early in the second period that this game is tied. They haven't generated many shots at all, and their goalie has been outstanding.
From the boards, he takes that pass. He scores, and he's up and running this season.
Look at the relief on his face already. He hasn't even played many games, but you want this as early as you can.
Tavares wins it in the dots. Along the right side into the offensive zone. Here he is with the backhander. Scores! They are on fire.
Yeah, and it's all different sources.
Ray Ferraro's between the benches picking up all the action. Is there any down there?
Well, there's a lot of excitement on one bench, right? I mean, everybody's pumped. The goals have been going in pretty quickly for them. The coach is still on them, though, to not let up. He goes right down to the rookie and gives him a little reminder. This game's not over yet.
Puck scooped up by Muzzin. Nice pass. Stays with it. Chicago's got the puck in their own end. Into the attacking end. Centering pass. Can't finish. Oh, Ray, it's a blown opportunity.
It really is. I mean, the play is sitting right there. There's a scoring chance to be had. They just don't execute it.
Nearing the midway mark of the period. Toronto's really controlled the pace. He scores!
Well, the old double dip makes this a fantastic night for you. You know it's your night. You're feeling it. And now he's got two.
The centers will glide into the dot. Chicago's won it. Moves it over to DeBrincat. And he slides it quickly to Kane. Right to the middle. Here's a shot. And there's the save. No quarter given here as they battle for the loose puck along the boards. Scooped up along the wall by Keith. Shoots it. Stopped by the goaltender. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Moves it quickly over to Kidd. Good heads up play in the defensive zone. Denies him on the slobber. Quick pass over to Peary. Chicago's in now. And a nice poke check inside the neutral zone. The Leafs gain possession along the wall. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Sends it across. A chance from the slot. Big time stop.
Subban's fought that puck all night long. He makes a good save there, James, but it's been a long night for him, and the guys in front of him haven't been much better.
Quick pass to Kane. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. The Blackhawks get a hold of it. Moves the puck. And the horn sounds to stop the bleeding, at least for a few minutes anyway. Moves it to Kane, and he slides it quickly to Keith. Reads the play and forces the turnover.
The Leafs have played an outstanding game. What stood out for me is when they don't have the puck, they get it back really quickly. It's been that way all night.
Denies him!
Subban sharp to make that stop.
McKayev. Here comes the pushback. Here we go.
James, I was really good at this. Not the fight part. I mean the first part where someone else comes in and fights for you.
Oh, and down to the ice he goes.
That's the end of that spirited bout. Well, that'll do it as they ride him off to the penalty box, each to their own bench to sit for 5 minutes. I hope he can get a drink of water. Last time in there, the bottle was empty, which really must stink because you're tired and thirsty, and now you get a bowl of dust.
You don't miss a thing, do you?
No, but I never was in there. Well, yeah, I was in there, and I hated when the bottle was empty.
Minnesota's up next on the schedule. Always a tough test, it feels like, in this league, isn't it?
Yeah, the prep will go once you get past this current game. Some guys don't want to know who's next. Some guys want to know everything in advance.
Chicago's got the puck along the wall. The Leafs have it against the wall. Quick pass across to Simmons. One-on-one with the goaltender. Denies him on the breakaway.
Really good speed to get out in front. Dust the pack. Now it's him and the goalie. But the goalie's better. He makes the stop.
Toronto's showing no signs of slowing down here in this third period, up big time. The Leafs win the faceoff. Handles the puck. Drills them. Sends a pass over. Along the half wall with the puck. Quick feed to Strome. Oh, and he just puts it wide of the net.
Oh, man, he's frustrated with himself. He's got to get that on the net.
Sends the pass over. Feed. Tries to feed it over to Peary. Simmons is taken down and the officials are signaling for a penalty. Breakaway. Oh, what a stop.
Goaltender comes up big in good position to make the save.
The Blackhawks are getting 2 minutes for tripping.
You see, hangs his head and heads towards the penalty box. It's always a frustrating penalty to take.
The final horn sound. Matthews' three-goal performance spurs this team on to victory, Ray.
What a shot in the arm would work.
The heat on the ice, these two teams do not like each other, and the fact that they come away with the win, little bragging rights for them. And tell you what, big difference maker in this one. I love the way the kid responded in this one. It was almost like, yeah, I want in on this. I want to have some fun. And he really was a difference maker in this historic rivalry matchup that I think a lot of fans were looking forward to seeing and watching them collide. Where do they go from here when you look at some of the numbers? Phones we go. It's John in High River who's on the line. Good evening, John.
How you doing, James?
I'm all right, thanks. What'd you make of that last night?
Well, one word, promising, especially from our rookie. Just seems to be getting a little bit better each and every game.
Yeah, you know what? He seems to fit in. I wasn't sure whether it was the right call for him to stick when the season started, but I'll tell you what, he's proven me wrong.
You know, you see some rookies, they look lost. He looks fine out there. He looks like he understands the game and he's ready to play at this level.
Yeah, picked up another apple last night and certainly trending in the right direction. Appreciate the call. Let's take a look at the rest of the action on the ice tonight in the National Hockey League. The Maple Leafs were in a dogfight on the road up against the Capitals. Washington pounded home the winner in overtime. The Flames had a tall order to fill as they tried to take two on the road against the Avalanche. Colorado terrorizes the opposition with a big goal-scoring night in the win. The Blues were looking to steal 2 points against the Blackhawks. St. Louis peppered the opposition goaltender early and often winning big. Hey, we got to pay a couple of bills here, but we got a lot more action we got to get to. Stay with us. All right, at this time, let's get you caught up on all the action on the ice tonight. The Blues had an on-ice collision with the Maple Leafs. St. Louis takes the win in a very close game. The Red Wings were hoping to fly high on the road against the Panthers. Florida presented their coaches with the best defensive effort we've seen all season with the shutout win. The Lightning played on the road against the Wild. Tampa Bay tore it up. Seemed like almost everybody got on the score sheet in the win. We'll check the inbox, we'll check the text line, and hear what you have to say next. Winnipeg. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. The Jets are closing out their homestand tonight and has been favorable for them here.
Not always the case, James. Sometimes you come home for a long stretch of games, the team plays poorly, the fans get agitated, one thing leads to another, and it's a rotten stain. Not this time.
Picked up along the wall by Wheeler. Puts it up front. Here he is from the slot, and that's blocked. The Leafs get a hold of the puck along the boards. Pokes it away to stay on the attack. Here he is, shot right in front. Came up with the save on that play.
Anderson's had a lot to do with the team's winning record. His save percentage has been excellent all season.
Toronto's got the puck. Takes the pass. Toronto's ready to go on the attack. Picked up along the boards by Tavares. Stopped by the goaltender.
We often talk about a goalie's reflexes. You've got to have quick hands to make a glove stop like that.
Ray Ferraro with a little comparison between the stars he's keeping tabs on. We like to call it the razor's edge, Ray.
When the coaches put the lines on the board, James, before the game, you know immediately who you're matched up against. We're going to see these guys butt heads all night long.
More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. We've still got zeros on the board. Hull stick handling in his own zone. Hammers one. Oh, you'll win respect for your teammates doing that. What a block. Taken along the wall by Brody. Couldn't complete the play. Slides it over with pace to Perreault. The Jets move it in. And now he moves it to Roslovic. Oh, what an effort giving up the body there. Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. Oh, what a save in front. Winnipeg's gained possession along the boards. Toronto's regained possession of the puck. Turns it away.
Great tracking. He finds the puck. He gets the glove up. Makes the save on a dangerous chance.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. That concludes the first period. Really, both teams still feeling each other out here as we are still scoreless.
slides the puck over. Wheeler's got it across the line. Toronto's got it in the neutral zone. Grabbed along the boards by DeMello. Takes a bump but still hangs on to the puck. Let's one go. Makes the save. Hull's taking it from his own end. Moves inside. Oh, and he can thank his stick for that one.
Brassois able to get out and make the save on that grade A chance.
Closes that gap along the wall. The Jets will play the puck from behind the net. Now a quick pass to Ehlers. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Toronto's got a hold of it against the wall. Lays the body. Winnipeg's got the puck here in the open ice. Toronto's got control of it now from their own end. Here's a short pass to Hyman. A chance in front! Stopped by the goaltender.
Yeah, he got out tight to him, James. There's nowhere for that puck to go.
There's another stop! Slides it diagonally to Connor. Circles back to center ice. From in close! Oh, what a stop by Anderson! Right up the gut, here they go. Moves it to Kidd. Unloads the shot! Too many bodies in the way. Muzzin's got it in the offensive zone. Good defensive stop with the poke check. Moves the puck along the half wall. Moves it quickly over to Kidd. Moved up ahead here in the neutral zone. Toronto's got the puck along the boards. He's got a step! Scores! Wow, what a goal!
Nice hands, great finish. Little short break and it's in the net.
Toronto's equalizer comes at a critical time of the game, late in a period, isn't it, Ray?
Anytime you give up a goal late in the period, you feel like you've given up more than that. So this is a critical goal.
Both teams have gotten on the board, and this one has been pretty much a dogfight through the first 40 minutes as the period comes to an end. Brody's got the puck in his own zone. Receives the pass. Here's an odd man rush. What a save! He'll probably feel that one tomorrow. Now over to Ehlers. Taken by Forbort. Loose puck battle along the boards. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. The Jets work it through center. Wheeler's got the puck. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Tavares looks around. How did he stop that one?
Had to be sharp. That's a grade A chance.
Winnipeg's got a hold of it along the wall. Nice zone entry from the middle. The Jets carry it along the wall. Quick pass to Forbort. The Leafs will play it in their own end. Pushes it across to Kidd. He got rocked again.
He's got to get his head up here. They're going to be carting him off the ice.
The Jets play it along the wing. Right in the slot, and that's broken up. Toronto's got it in their own zone. Oh, he'll feel that one. Angles it over to Stastny. And now he angles it across to Ehlers. From the slot, wrist shot. Oh, what a blocker stop by Anderson.
Oh, he reads the play really well to get out and aggressive to make that save.
Moves the puck into the attacking area. An easy save by Brassois. Stastny's got the puck along the wing. Trying to get back on the attack now. Toronto's looking to break out. Takes the feed. Pokes the puck away.
It's a great way to protect the lead. Get it deep into the offensive zone and try and run around on the forecheck a little bit. Kill the clock when you can.
Back to the point it goes. Stopped by the goaltender.
Anderson's been sharp stopping the puck tonight. He's got a really good save percentage, and his team's done a good job at the offensive zone as well.
Here we are in this third period. Ray, who's got the razor's edge tonight?
Kid's made a living out of finishing around the front of the net. I think that's the difference tonight for me, James, in the razor's edge.
Can't find his man. Here's a shot. Takes that one right in the logo. Wasa's going to hang on for a whistle here in the third.
Well, there's not much time left here as you get into the final 20 minutes. The game's close. A mistake now would be critical.
In the final moments of this period, the Leafs lead it 4-2. Winnipeg's got possession here in their own end. Through center along the wing. They've got numbers. Here he is in front. Big save.
I like the goalie's positioning here. He was aggressive enough to make a save on a dangerous chance.
And he scores, which should end it.
That should wrap it up. Pretty comfortable now with that empty netter.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. That's it. There's the final horn to close this one up. Toronto's effort far from perfect, but when they had the puck, there was a lot to like.
Yeah, just take what you got tonight. I think, you'd like to have the puck more.
Phones we go. Let's check in with Rebecca in Bayside. How are you?
I'm good. Yeah, I'm feeling good about the Rook. I try not to get too high or too low based on his performances earlier on. Sometimes that's not easy for me to do, but this is just a good all-around game, right? And I don't just look at the score sheet. It's great to be putting up points, but I'm more concerned on if he's putting in the effort, right? Is he back-checking? Is he leading by example? Is he really trying to earn his spot, even though he is kind of that star rookie? And I was impressed. I thought he played a really solid game and was a big reason for the W.
Rebecca, or Becky, if you don't mind, answer me this legitimately. You took this kid in your fantasy team, didn't you?
I did, yeah. I'm a little biased.
You're totally.
Are we all?
Yeah, it sounds so emotionally invested already. I'm amazed at this.
I know, I am.
Yeah, that's all right. Hey, I thought, you know what? I would have taken a flyer on the kid, too. I like what I've seen as well. All right, thanks very much for the call. All right, time for a quick break. Well, some fun, some drama, a little bit of everything on the ice tonight. All right, let's take a look at some of those scores around the league. Doug Chant had it. Welcome back to the show, everybody. James Cebulski with you. And as promised, my broadcast partner in crime, Ray Ferraro, who I know has missed me so much, joins us on the line. How are you, man?
I have not missed you at all, James. Not at all. Doing good, though. Doing good, man.
Awesome. Are you not surprised at the conversation already surrounding the Calder here after the first month?
A little bit, but I think it's because these kids come into the NHL now and they're better prepared to perform and produce than they've ever been. I mean, this is just a few weeks into the season, and you've got people so excited about the way these kids play, and in particular, the rookie here has been outstanding. Man, there's a long way to go, but he's a front runner already.
Yeah, no, he has looked really impressive in the eyes, and you know, we've talked about him a lot on the broadcasts, and he has certainly been an encouraging talent. Let's take a look around the league and some of the final scores out there tonight. The Stars had a tall order to fill as they tried to take two on the road against the Red Wings. Detroit takes this one in a nail biter. The Oilers took to the road to match up with the Blackhawks. Chicago put up a strong fight and they do enough to get the win. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Toronto, Ontario. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. Lots of time left in this period. Still scoreless in this one. Calgary's won the draw. Here's a chance to clear the puck from his own end. Off the glass and out of the zone. Consider that a win for the penalty killers for now.
You bet it is. Now they can get a change, get some fresh people on the ice.
Here's a chance, and he comes up with it. Denies him again.
A after the first stop, he's in good position to make a second.
And a successful clearing attempt. Toronto's got the puck along the wall. Thornton's got it into offensive territory. Off his stick! Oh, and comes up with nothing on the play. And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. And they manage to clear it. The Leafs gain control of the puck against the wall. Quick feed to Kidd. Gives them nothing in front.
But he came out and challenged him. Good save.
While we have a minute, let's send it between the benches where Ray Ferraro is standing by with tonight's Razor's Edge.
Hey, James, I'm looking at a couple of players that play a pretty similar style of game. One of them will have something to do with the outcome.
Takes a shot. He scores! That's how you do it! Leadership to a T! The captain capitalizes! The Leafs have had multiple scoring opportunities here in this first and could easily have a much bigger lead.
Scored by number 9.
On the attack along the boards. The Flames gain possession along the wall. Calgary's got a hold of the puck. And now he tries to get it across to Tkachuk. The Flames looking against the half wall. Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck. Grabs control of it at the point. Centered out in front, and that's picked off. Nice zone entry from the right side. Calgary's got the puck against the wall. Here in the back half of this period, the Leafs have recently taken a two-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. Through pass ahead. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. Tries to dangle, and the puck skips away.
There are times you try to do too much. He's got good hands, but maybe a more simple play's the right one there.
And now it's over to Tkachuk. Gets in front of it. Here's a short pass to Hull. Carries the puck up through center. Scooped up along the wall by Brody. Here's a chance. Slides it across. Can't connect. The Flames scoop it up along the boards. Nice pass.
No, he's only one goal.
He scores!
Oh, there's a nice one. 200 career goals for him now.
First period comes to an end. I'll tell you what, anybody who bought a ticket for this one, feeling like they got their money's worth. Moves it to Tavares. The Leafs have it now. And here's the pass to Kidd. Pokes it away in his own end. Quick shot! Scores! He's on the board!
Doesn't seem like much, James, but it's amazing at the start of a year how no goals in 3 games, 4 games, 5 games starts to weigh heavy on a player.
Moves the puck. Calgary's on the attack. Right out front! Stick save and a beaut by Anderson.
He's sharp on this one. Out on top of the crease aggressively to make the save.
Stones him in front.
Anderson's been sharp when he's had to be. He's got a good save percentage here tonight, and his team's in good shape.
Grips it and rips it! Denies him on the play! Kidd's taking the puck behind the net. Denies him in front. Great reflexes, another save. And on the heels of that being hit, he's being called out.
He's going to need some help here. He's pretty clearly struggling on the ice. Banged up in this shift somewhere. Just wants to get the puck out to center ice and get the heck off the ice.
Works it across to Ryan. Smart defensive play there. The Leafs have it against the wall. Through center. And that's intercepted. Hennepin's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. And here's the official call as play is whistled dead. Kidd's getting called for tripping.
It's a tough penalty to take. You're trying to do the right thing. Unfortunately, you pull his feet out, you got to go to the penalty box.
Puts it on net, denied by the goaltender. Scores!
The power play and cashed in earlier. They do so again here. Really nice effort with the extra man.
Moves it quickly over to Kidd. Here's a shot, and he makes the save.
Hanifin's trying to change a few things up. This pointless streak is starting to nag at him.
The Leafs have generated plenty of quality scoring chances and a big reason why they lead late in the second period. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Period number two is in the books. There's been no shortage of offense tonight.
The Flames have a little more room on the bench, and that's because their injured player is not going to return tonight. He was evaluated in the locker room, and the doctors are going to hold him out.
Thanks very much for the update, Ray. That certainly complicates things now going forward. Quick pass to Hyman. Feeds the puck across to Tavares. Quick feed to Hyman. Whoa. And scores!
Sometimes it's just your night. He's got his second goal of the game.
Do you continue to press here with the lead, Razor, or do you try to play it safe?
Well, it's a fine line, but the coach is reminding the players that safety trumps everything else. If a play's there, make it. But for the most part, they want that puck in front of them and playing a defensive posture.
The Leafs are on cruise control here in this third period, leading big. They've got the defense outnumbered. Great stop by Anderson.
And by number 90.
Kidd swooping in on the attack.
3 minutes and 24 seconds.
The Flames get a hold of the puck along the boards. Here they come. Gets it to the other point. Oh, gets a paddle on it. What a stop by Anderson. From the point, looks to make something happen. And they come up empty-handed. Takes a shot, denied by the goaltender. Right in front, deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. And there's the hat trick as he delivers again.
James, if you're a goal scorer, you think about a night where everything goes well. This is what it looks like for a player.
Dishes it to Tavares. Slides the puck ahead to Hyman. Sends a pass over. Puck grab by Kidd. Drives to the crease. Picked up along the wall by Hyman. And that pass goes awry. Calgary's got it in the offensive zone. Right in the slot. Stopped by the goaltender. Let's send it back down between the benches. Ray Ferraro gives us the answer to the Razor's edge.
Kidd's play tonight made him stand out. You couldn't help but notice how productive he was throughout the evening.
Long lead pass into the neutral zone. All alone! Oh, what a stop on the breakaway!
Good speed to break ahead of the pack. He thinks he's got the goalie beat, but shut down. That's a great stop.
Dallas is up next on the schedule. Always a fun tilt for these two teams.
Yeah, the fans of both sides love to get together to watch these two teams play, rather. It is usually an aggressive, physical game. I suspect there'll be a lot of fun in that one.
Made the stop on the play. Nearing the final minute of the third.
1 minute left.
Handles the puck. Calgary's got it along the wall. And he was right there. They can't connect. The Leafs take it along the wing. Not able to connect. Quick pass across to Ryan. Calgary's got the puck in the defensive end. Here's a shot, and that one's turned away. And it's a quick pass to Riley. Takes the feed, moving in. Takes a slap shot from the point. Big save by the goaltender. Toronto's offense has not been a problem tonight. They put a lot of shots on net and lead it big time late in this third period. And now it's grabbed by Tanev. Moves the puck to the attacking area. Here's a blast. Big time stop. Battle along the boards. Manages to hang on. And there's the final horn, bringing this one to an end. Hyman's hat trick. Back of the ice, solid team effort there. To the phones we go. Who's on line three? Hello.
Hey, it's Brendan from Burlington.
Hey, Brendan, what's on your mind?
I'm starting to really like what I'm seeing from our rookie. This is a multi-point game, and he's looked great out there. He's been really good this season. He's been like a real bright spot for us, and I think that we maybe found somebody that we can really build around.
You know, and you look at the gradual evolution, you know, the storylines coming into camp. Can he stick? Showing he belongs right through all the exhibition games. And here we are now as he carries it into the regular season. I like what I'm seeing. Here's hoping there's no rookie wall because I'm buying what he's selling. All right, back to the phones we go. Okay, everybody, let's take a quick look at some of the final scores around the league tonight. The Flames were hoping to play spoiler against the Maple Leafs. Toronto triumphs in this one thanks to a complete effort at all ends of the ice. The Wild played on the road against the Canucks. Minnesota powers their way to victory, showing a lot of grit in both ends of the ice. Hey, a few more hot button issues we gotta get to. It's a jam-packed show tonight. Stick around. Now let's take a look at some of the rest of the action tonight in the NHL. The Blackhawks took to the ice to battle the Canucks. Chicago takes this one thanks to a strong defensive effort. We got to take a quick break, everybody, but we've got a lot more to get to. Stay with us. Let's take a look at the scoreboard and what went down tonight on the ice. The Canes were on the road to take on the Coyotes. Arizona perseveres through the night, and they get to the shootout where they pick up the extra point in the win. The Cats took to the ice to lock up with the Jets. Winnipeg tightened it up late when they needed to most, and they pick up the 2 points. The Avs took to the road to match up with the Canucks. Vancouver puts in a workmanlike effort in this one, and they get the win. A very special guest drops by on the show, and we'll do that next.